Caroline, you're 56. Yes. Sport has been a major part of your life since you were 4 years old. Why is competing so important to you?
It's been a big sense of my identity. It's always something I've been good at with rugby and athletics and the other sports I did. My family were huge on playing sport when I was younger, and just a sense of community and fitting in with everyone. So that's why it was really important to me.
So. You took part in men's athletics and rugby union until your 30th birthday when you transitioned from male to female. What reception did you get when you started playing women's rugby?
Well, the first year, I had a coach who told me to just keep it quiet because otherwise I wouldn't make any rep teams. Yeah, and I had a really successful year. I was nominated for the Sydney Morning Herald Rugby Awards for one of the top six players in New South Wales. And then there was talk about me possibly being in the Australian team for the next World Cup. So that the first 12 months was just... it was like a real honeymoon period for me.
What was it like to have to keep it quiet?
It's very tough because I was always looking over my shoulder thinking, how would these people treat me if they knew that I was trans? And I'm not sure if some had suspicions.
It took a year before your teammates found out you were transgender. How did they react?
At first it wasn't too bad, but it became worse as time went on, and then it just sort of... it went viral, you know. I was bullied by some teammates and... both club and rep level, and I was pretty much made a pariah. And in 2005, that was my annus horribilis. That was a really, really tough year for me, and it just was not an easy year to endure.